Flat belts like this are a little bit of a mystery of physics. They magically manage to stay tracking without any sort of flanges on the pulleys. And even if I push this belt to the side a little bit like that, now if I turn it, it just magically comes back on center. So I'll show you why it does this with a little demo piece I built. So here I've got the Lego belt transmission with a exaggerated crown pulley here, and these two wheels kind of form a flat pulley. And I've got a belt on here, and so let's move this off to the side. And so now we've got it offline, and let me just make sure it's off here as well. And now I'm just going to turn this, and look what happens. It just magically wanders back onto the center. So how the heck does it do this? The key to what makes a flat belt track on center is how the belt stretches. So I'm using this piece of rubber band to show you. So if I'm going to pull this rubber band just on the one edge like this, it forms an arc. Like you can see in the middle there, even where I'm not touching it, it forms a curve. And if I pull on the other side, it forms another curve. And this curvature, when I stretch this band asymmetrically, is key to what makes the belt come back on track. So I've put the belt on here to be off-center, and because this part of the pulley is higher than this part, it pulls more on this side of the pulley. And I only really need to do this on the one side, because the effect doesn't need to be very strong. So you can not quite see it, but this belt actually curves. And now if I just turn it, and it's on center, like magic. Even though this belt here is actually not entirely straight, because it's just a piece of rubber band that was attached to some broccoli I got from the grocery store. Most machinery nowadays is just powered by V-belts because they're much easier to deal with. You don't need very much tension on them, and they can deal with a lot of misalignment. But they're not very efficient, and they can't be run at very high speed. So in this application, this fan here is powered by a motor running 3500 RPM, and the belt steps it up to 11,000 RPM, which is much more than a V-belt could, and it's also much more efficient. Let me show you by turning it on. And as you watch it spin down, you can see it just keeps running for a long time because the flat belt is very efficient, has very little friction to it. The principle that keeps a flat belt tracking on a crown pulley is also exploited by a bandsaw. The bandsaw wheels also have a slight crown on them, although it's kind of hard to see under the blade right now. And that's what keeps the blade, which acts as a belt, centered on the two wheels. Now on a bandsaw there's always a little adjustment knob which allows you to tilt the top wheel, just in case your belt has a tendency to wander to either side, so you can sort of bring it back in or adjust how the blade tracks. Let me demonstrate how that works with this bandsaw. So let me just turn it on. And we can see the blade is tracking on here. Now if I adjust this the tilt on the top wheel, that will throw it off a little bit. So you can now see that the blade has moved forward. And now if I put the top pulley straight again, it'll immediately go right on top again. So that's how it does it in a bandsaw. I've actually seen a bandsaw mill that had no blade guides and just relied on the tracking of the crown pulleys to keep the blade aligned. In fact, the blade had teeth on either edge, so this tracking can actually hold quite a lot of force.